a major fight this weekend. Artur Bitterbayev, 3 belts in the 175 division, fighting Colin Smith. Colin Smith, this is his moment to shine. It's a 50-50 fight. Of course, we're all looking forward to the unification bout, the undisputed bout versus Bivol. Whoever wins this fight should fight Bivol next, and we're looking forward to it. However, breaking news today, Kevin Ioli reported that in Nevada test from December 6th, they found some atypical finding in a system of high levels of HGH and testosterone. Nothing that broke the rules. The fight's going forward, but Eddie Hearn had this to say. He spoke exclusively to Boxing News Plus, and he says, "I feel like there needs to be more transparency. We're not scientists, but we read the information, and of course, it raises concerns." So that's what Eddie Hearn says. If it's not normal in a test, then why is it allowed? And if it's normal, then why mention it? So, you know, can't have it both ways. We're not scientists. We know, and I love when boxing media acts like they're expert in contracts, they're expert in negotiations, they're experts in chemistry and physics, and they're experts in everything, except maybe boxing, because I've seen their pound for pound. They don't even know boxing, but they're experts in everything else. But back to the subject. Artur Bitterbayev, 19-0, 19 knockouts, had an atypical finding for raised levels of HGH, testosterone, metabolite, 5D, androstadiol. I can't even pronounce it. I don't know what that is. I'm not a scientist, as I mentioned. In December 6th, Vada drug test ahead of his fight with Colin Smith on Saturday. However, both substances occur naturally in the body, and an atypical finding is not a violation like an adverse finding, a positive test. So the fight is set to go on ahead because a follow-up test requested by Vada, all were negative. So that's one. And here is what Artur Bitterbayev's team has put out there to Kevin Ioli, but it says it's from him. It's a statement. "It has come to my attention that Colin Smith intends to disseminate misleading information about my Vada test for the fight. Let me be clear now. I am a clean athlete. I have never tested positive for a banned substance throughout my career. Any attempt to imply otherwise through innuendo or suggestion is slanderous and libelous. This conduct is beyond acceptable trash talk. Colin is already searching for excuses, looking for a way out. See you Saturday." Obviously, Bitterbayev did not write that statement. He barely speaks English. And that brings me to a whole nother topic, that when fighters put a statement on social media and it's not them, it's their team, just put a little asterisk, say team. It's okay. But don't try to fool everybody and say, I could tell in 2 seconds if it's a fighter tweeting or his team. Everybody else could too. But Bitterbayev's team is pretty mad over this. They're heated. They say, I'm a clean athlete. I never failed a test. Just because you didn't fail a test doesn't mean, I'm not saying about Bitterbayev, I'm saying in general, it just means you could beat the system. Just means you know. But definitely, if there's things in a system that shouldn't be there, that's not normal, then it's not normal. Like I said, if it's okay and he has a doctor's note and it's approved or whatever the case may be, then why even mention it? If it's not okay, then he shouldn't be fighting, one of the two. So they have to sort this out. They have to make it very clear. The whole thing with Vada needs to be out of boxing. They need to bring in a new agency that charges way less. Maybe that's why the UFC are doing their own thing. It's way cheaper to do it in-house. I was going to talk to some scientists and some laboratories to do their own testing for boxing. And instead of charging $30,000 for the test, which is right now, to charge way less. Way, way less, and test everybody 0-0 to 50-0. So that's the big news today. We'll see where it goes. But Eddie Hearn says, reason for concerns. Bitterbayev says, hey, slanderous, libelous. I'm a clean athlete. I never failed a test. Stay tuned. VegasNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Sekback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekback. I'm Ellie Sekback. Ellie Sekback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.